welcome to Suncoast. I visited Bratislava in early summer of 2024. I came to Bratislava from Vienna by car. Of course, I was accompanied by my dog, Bella, and the trip was very short from Vienna to Bratislava. It's a short distance. The city is quite beautiful and it has a very rich history. Bratislava is the capital of Slovakia and has a population of approximately 475,000, or roughly 9% of the 5.4 million in the country. It is located in the southwestern corner of the Little Carpathians, and it occupies both banks of the Danube and Morava rivers. Slovakia is landlocked and borders Poland, Ukraine, Hungary, Austria, and the Czech Republic. The city of Bratislava itself borders two sovereign states, Hungary and Austria. That makes Bratislava the only capital in the world to border two sovereign states. Slovakia has a long history. The oldest findings date back to 270,000 BC, which is the early Paleolithic, and from 200,000 BC, a Neanderthal cranium. There are also artifacts dating back to 22,800 BC. Cultures came and disappeared in the Bronze and Iron Ages, including Thracians. From about 500 BC, the area where Bratislava is located was populated by Celtic tribes, and later there is evidence of a Dacian influence. The Romans conquered the area in the 1st to the 4th century, and the area was made part of the Danubian line border defense system. The Romans cultivated grapes and produced wine, and the area continues the same tradition today. Roman ruins can be seen in Bratislava. The Roman domination ended with the arrival of various migratory people, including the Huns, Avars, and Slavs. The Slavs appeared in Slovakia in the 5th century, and until about 1000 AD, they more or less fought and roughly maintained control over the area, with the greatest territorial gains made by the Great Moravia Empire. The area was also part of the Kingdom of Poland after the collapse of the Moravia Empire. Slovakia was conquered by the Hungarians and from 1048 to 1918 became part of the Hungarian Kingdom. But in 1526, the Battle of Mohacs resulted in a crushing defeat for the Hungarians by the Ottomans, and Buda fell to the Ottomans in 1541. Until 1718, much of the Kingdom of Hungary, including Buda and Pest, was under Ottoman control. The Ottomans besieged and damaged Bratislava, but failed to conquer it. During the Ottoman occupation of Buda in 1536, the Hungarian Kingdom moved its capital to Pressburg, which is modern-day Bratislava. Bratislava, known as Pressburg back then, remained the legislative center and coronation site for the Kingdom of Hungary until 1783. St. Martin's Cathedral saw the coronation of 11 Hungarian kings and 8 queens during this period. The capital was moved back to Budapest during the Hungarian Reform era. In the 17th century, the city was marked by all kinds of events such as floods, fighting with the Ottomans, plagues, epidemics, and other disasters that greatly diminished the population. In the 18th century, during the reign of Queen Maria Theresa, the city flourished and became the largest and most important town in the Kingdom of Hungary. The population tripled and a lot of new construction took place. Mozart, Haydn, and Beethoven were in the city and performed. Before World War I, the city had a population that was 42% German, 41% Hungarian, and 15% Slovak. After World War I, in 1919, the census declared the city's ethnic composition as 36% German, 33% Slovak, and 29% Hungarian. Probably reflecting a change in self-identification rather than a change in the population. After the fall of the Austro-Hungarian Empire in 1918, Slovakia and Czechia became united, forming Czechoslovakia. In 1918, the name of the city was still called Pressburg, as it had been for centuries. But it was felt that the new state, Czechoslovakia, needed a more Slavic-sounding name. Influential American Slovaks at the time were proposing the name Wilsonov after the US President Woodrow Wilson, who supported national self-determination. But the founders settled on the name Bratislava. After 1948, when the communists took over and the city became part of the Eastern Bloc, the city annexed new land and the population rose significantly, becoming 90% Slovak. In 1989, Slovakia and Czechia separated, forming two separate states. Today, Bratislava is a noticeably dynamic city with quite a bit of construction going on. It's a fairly rich city with almost three times the gross domestic product and purchasing power over other Slovak regions. I really enjoyed Bratislava and I recommend visiting the city. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe.